Hey everyone, welcome to Aftershoot. In today's tutorial video, we're gonna go over how to cull and edit images that are already inside of your Lightroom catalog. As always, with edits, it works a little bit faster when you have smart previews built. So what I'm gonna do is show you the import process here. So I'm gonna go ahead and find the catalog I would like to import. So we're gonna go ahead and click on this one, and I'm gonna import these files. Now, some of them already are imported. My apologies, please ignore the ones that do have stars and colors on them already because they haven't been culled yet. So once these import, I've already selected that I'd like it to build the smart previews for me. So it's going to automatically build these smart previews as soon as this completes. So these images will be imported. And as you can see, now the smart previews are being built. Now, while this is happening, what I can actually do is go ahead and open Aftershoot and I can run my cull. So I'm gonna go ahead and start culling, add a folder. We're gonna find that folder here and I'm gonna cull the folder. So it'll be culling while the smart previews are building. You can do the both processes at the same time, but you can't actually edit and cull at the same time. There is one step, and that's the whole point of this video. All of it leads up to this one really important step, because if you don't do it, you either won't have your stars or colors, or you won't have your edits. One or the other is gonna disappear on you. So we're gonna go ahead and start culling here. I will let it run through, and we can go and check on our smart previews. So they're being built as we speak. That'll help our editing speed quite a bit. As you can see, these images are importing. There's 114 of them, although I do believe I'm gonna select all here and I'm going to drag and drop them into a collection because I personally like to use collections. So there's 140 here. As you can see, those are the ones that were already culled before. What I'm gonna do is let this cull complete. And as soon as it completes, I'm gonna head into Lightroom before I start my edits, because I have one really important step, and that important step is reading the metadata before I run editing. And the reason you have to do this is because if you don't, you will either overwrite your edits or you won't be able to import your stars and colors. So it's one or the other. So you gotta make sure that you do this middle step in order for both the stars and colors to appear and for your edits not to disappear. So my cull is complete. You can see there's 28 selected photos. I am in library mode in Lightroom now. I'm gonna select all of the images and I'm gonna head to metadata, read metadata from files. Now you're gonna notice these images that have 5 stars, the edits are gonna disappear on them. And this is why this step is so important, because we have to get the stars and colors in first before we run the editing, because the edits get overwritten when you read the metadata. Now that that's completed, I can go ahead and quit my Lightroom catalog. All my folders are imported, all my stars and colors are there, and I will head back to home, click on edit. I will choose the AI profile I want to use. I'm gonna not crop and straighten here, no need to. I'm gonna choose my most recent Lightroom catalog. The smart previews will automatically connect. I'll click on continue. I'm gonna choose this collection because this is the collection I wanna edit, and I'm gonna clear my filters because I only wanna edit those 28 photos. So I'm just gonna edit the 5-star photos here. So we'll go ahead and click on edit, and it's gonna run through, pardon me. It was 31 photos because some were already imported from before. So fantastic, it's gonna run through and get these 31 photos edited for us. Now the smart previews, because we had the smart previews, you can see it just skipped the whole generating preview step. So it just goes a lot faster here. As you can see, it's all done now, 31 images edited. I clicked the review in Lightroom button, and now we're gonna land on our edited photos. So as you can see, pop in here and we'll just go to those 5 stars. So what I'll do now is actually filter down to the 5 stars, those 31 photos, so I can just see the edits that Aftershoot Edits applied. And now, like I said, if you were to now read the metadata, and I'll show you what that looks like on just these images, if I select all, metadata, read metadata from files, which is how you would get the stars and colors in, you can see all of the edits we just created disappeared. So that's why you have to make sure you read the stars and colors before you get the catalog edited. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions at all, don't forget, we have 24/7 in-app support that can help guide you through any of these workflows. And of course, be sure to check out some of our other videos to learn what Aftershoot can do for you.